Hi, everybody. This is Ian Lamont from In 30 Minutes Guides, including Microsoft Word in 30 Minutes and our popular line of cheat sheets. If this video helps you out, please take a chance to subscribe or like to it. But let's get started with the situation here. And what I want to do is I want to have my MacBook have two external monitors showing different things. And having two different things is actually pretty important because as I discovered when I first tried to do this, I used a cheap adapter that hooked up my MacBook to two monitors, but they showed the same thing, which was useless to me because I really wanted to have two things going on at once. So like on this screen, a browser, on this screen, an open Microsoft Word document or Google Docs or a spreadsheet or something like this. So this is how you do it. So first of all, most of you who have MacBooks know that your MacBook doesn't really include much in the way of adapters anymore. Usually it's two USB-C adapters, and that's all you have. So you need to get some sort of adapter to get the signal from these monitors, which is an HDMI signal, into your MacBook. And here is one of the mistakes that I made when I first tried to do this. I found a low-cost adapter that had multiple HDMI inputs in it. And basically, I would take the cables from these two, plug it into here, and then hook it up to my MacBook. But the problem was when I activated it, it would only show the same thing on both of the monitors, which was useless to me. So I had to get another. I had to look around for a solution, and actually the solution was this: Apple's own adapter. And they don't look like much. There's only three things on the end of it. One of them, I'll bring it a little bit closer. One of them is HDMI. This is USB-C, which is actually pretty important because you can power devices through this. And then there's also just a simple regular USB receiver, which I use for my wireless mouse. So you need one of these if you want to have two monitors going on. And I've tested this with both the new M1 chip Macs, as well as this is an older MacBook from a couple years ago that has the previous type of processor on it. And this technique works for both to get two separate things going on. So this is what you do. I'm going to use this one just for one of the monitors, and I'm going to use this one for the other monitor. But actually, if you wanted to, you could just get a very simple adapter USB to HDMI. It doesn't have all this extra stuff. But for the sake, just to show you how it works, I'm just going to use this as one of my adapters, and this is the other one. So you have the two monitors. They're plugged in, and they both have HDMI cables coming out of them. I don't know which one is which, but it doesn't matter because later on when I arrange the screens, everything will look good. So first things first. Hook up one of the screens to the HDMI adapter. I'm going to hook it up to the Mac one, to the official Apple adapter. And by the way, these cost I think about $60 or $70 at an Apple store. I bought a couple of them, and these are actually a little bit less, but they're not as functional. But they do the job for just one screen. So, hook it up, plug it in. Then I'm going to unplug the power from this and hook it up to the USB-C port here, and then plug that back into the Mac. I have two ports, and now it'll flash on and off when you hook up different monitors. And the reason is because whenever you're adjusting the monitor and unplugging something, it'll turn off while it resets itself. So you can see that this is the active monitor. Now let's hook up the other one. So I'm going to use this cheapo adapter. HDMI in, and then I plug the other end into here. You can see it just flashed on. Everything turns off, and it should come back on. It's thinking about it. Okay, that's good. Now I have three different screens going on here. I'm going to shut this. Actually, no, I can't shut it because... Or I can shut it. Yeah, I think my mouse will work. Let's see if it does. Because I need a mouse to be able to use it. All right, so this wireless mouse is working. I'm going to shut this screen, the MacBook screen. It'll probably turn off again. It does. We'll turn back on. And I have two different screens going on. Now, one thing you should know, there's actually a main screen and a secondary screen. Sometimes it may be reversed, but I'll show you how to arrange that in a second. What you should do, the first thing when you get this set up, is go to the displays. You go to the system preferences, and I'm just going to bring this over so you can see it a little bit better, and click on displays. And basically what's going to happen is you're going to have two separate kind of dialogues for each display you have going on. If you take a look, if you come to this screen and it's showing the same thing like I'm showing you right now, what you need to do is go to the arrangement tab on one of them. And here it says mirror displays, uncheck that. So now I have two separate displays. On the left, this one, and on the right, it's this one. You can mess around with things like the refresh rate. If you want to, if it doesn't look right, like something's getting cut off or it looks too fuzzy, you can get around to adjusting the scaled, like 1080i versus 1080p versus 720p, but this looks okay for me. So I'm just gonna say default for display. The other thing that comes up is sometimes people want to, first of all, they want to change the primary monitor. So right now the primary monitor for me is the left one. I'm going to switch it to the right one. And basically how you do that is you'll see there's two monitors. You'll grab the white bar that's on the top of one of them, and then you'll just kind of transfer it to the other one. So now this is the main monitor. This is the secondary one. Let's bring that over for a second because I want to show one other thing. The other thing that happens sometimes is the monitors are reversed. Like right now I'm going left to right, right to left, okay. But sometimes it may look like this. Like I have to go to go from here to here. I don't slide my mouse to the right. It'll just stop moving. I have to slide it to the left and then it will come out here on the other side. So if that happens to you, it's easy. Basically, you have to just drag and drop these until they're in the right position. So I'm going to drag this and drop it over here. And here we go. So what I can do now is I can have two different programs running. So I can have, let's say, Safari. I'm going to move that over to the left monitor, just dragged it over. And then on this side, I can have, let's say, activity monitor. And that opened up on the other side of the screen. So I'm gonna just bring that over here. And then like, let's say that I was using Safari to go to Google Drive and I was typing in information I got here. I could look at them at the same time and have them as references. And this really, if you're doing like serious editing work or you need multiple windows open at the same time, this is a lot easier to deal with than the standard kind of flipping back and forth between windows because one of them is covering up the other one. This will give you a lot more screen real estate. So for more information on how to get the most out of your computer, the software you use, I have all kinds of videos on our YouTube channel. Please subscribe to it if this interests you. Also, if this video helped you out, if you could like it, I would be greatly appreciative. This is Ian Lamont signing off. Thank you so much for watching.